It is my honor to introduce Dr. G. Satish Reddy, Secretary, Department of Defense R&D and Chairman, DRDO. Dr. Reddy is well known for his significant contributions towards indigenous design, development, deployment of diversified missiles and strategic systems, guided weapons, avionics technologies, and for sustained efforts in the advancement of aerospace technologies and industries in India. Dr. Reddy, I request you to please deliver the valedictory address.
Very good afternoon. General Naravane, Chief of Army Staff and Senior Officers of the MOD, Mission Nitin Gokhale, the man behind Bharat Shakti and all others from Bharat Shakti, the military advisor to NSCS, General Khandare, most importantly, the defense attaches of various embassies which are located here in India, and the friends from industry. Very good afternoon to all of you once again. At the outset, let me thank Mr. Nitin Gokhale for inviting me to have a talk with you all people about the perspectives of the indigenous developments of various technologies in the country. Last year also, I think I have been here, and I think the same position in the valedictory I was positioned. And so it is a fixed position. Good to have that position. Coming to the scenario of various technologies in the country, in India, some of the technologies are matured, some of the technologies are maturing, and some of the advanced technologies at the stage of beginning of the research and development in that. Coming to the environment, industries have come up well in the country. Academia has come up well into the same plane. There are many academic institutes and professors who are able to understand the problems which are connected to the Ministry of Defense, and they're able to participate on the same plane, and they're able to take off from the same plane. Today, we have about more than 300 academic institutes working on defense-related research projects. Lots of people, I think Ministry of Defense has almost invested about more than 1,000 crores into the academic institutes here in the country. And we are able to work with them on many projects today, close to about 300 projects. Coming to the industries, there are close to about 2,000 industries, which are tier one and tier two industries in the country, meaning who are able to deliver the systems or subsystems. I'm not getting into the components level and other suppliers who are about more than 10,000. There are many industries which were earlier only built to print, now have come up to the stage of built to specifications, BTS. So they're able to develop many systems and make the system development in the country very fast. In fact, when we are talking about some of the new systems, what we are developing, so we are able to give very aggressive schedules. Out of the industry which has come up is able to take up most of the current systems which are there and whose development and deployment they're able to do into these aircrafts. We're talking about particularly aircrafts. When I talk about the LCA Mark II or the new generation, fifth plus generation aircraft AMCA, the schedules what we are working are very aggressive schedules. And people have been asking me, how can you meet this? My answer always has been that many of the systems which are going into this, industries are able to do. We are only concentrating mostly on the new systems which have to come up. Lots of schemes have come in the country where encouragement to the industry in the research and development, whether it is large-scale industries or MSMEs or startups, whether promoting the innovation or promoting the research in these industries. From DRDO, I think you are aware, we have already announced 108 items. which we said DRDO will not do the R&D of these systems. Industry has the capability, industry should be doing the design, development, and then production by themselves. And I'm sure in the coming couple of months, we'll come with some more numbers also. That's all. Similarly, country has come up in many technological areas. And so, MOD has already notified 101 items where you should not be importing because the country has the capability. Today, I can very confidently say, as the head of the R&D organization in the country, that the country is self-reliant in the areas of missiles, radars, sonars, AWC and electronic warfare systems, torpedoes, communication systems, and related many other systems which are there, even in the guns and related areas also, with couple of guns coming out of the country. So many technologies, the basic technologies which are required in these have been developed in the country. If you look at, when I give an example of radars, the fundamental elements which are required in that, right from a TR module, the transmit-receive module, at various frequencies have been developed. There are about 3 to 4 industries who are able to supply in large numbers today in the country. The gallium arsenide foundry is established, and in fact, even gallium nitride foundry is also established. I think the full frequency spectrum band should be available in the gallium nitride also by next year. Even the MEMS facilities have been established in the country. And even the foundry, when it comes to, we have today in the country multiple foundries. We have 180 nanometer foundry at SCL Chandigarh. As I said, gallium arsenide, gallium nitride foundry is there at GATEC Hyderabad. And then there is also a MEMS fabrication facility which is at Bangalore Star. So there are many infrastructure related basic fundamental things which are required. As I was saying in the radar, so right from the fundamental elements, right from a gallium nitride, the gallium arsenide device onwards to TR modules, and then the whole system, and the, making the systems today from very small radar to very, very long range radars. The country has developed the capabilities where you are able to go to thousands of kilometers range also for multiple platforms, including the AESA radar, active electronic scanning array radar, for the airborne platforms also. That is the situation. I just took the example of radar. Whatever I have talked about other areas of self-reliance, they are also similar, where you are able to do right from the fundamental element what is required in that and try to do that. So, as I said, the country has established itself in many strong areas, and many areas it's coming up. As I said, when we enter into the aircraft, when we are able to come out with 5 plus or 5.5 generation AMCA aircraft, that establishes the complete stealth technologies in the country. And then all the 5.5 generation aircraft technologies we are able to put in the country, probably in the coming 5 to 6 years, all these technologies will be proven and we should be able to come out. But then, friends, internationally or otherwise, lots of emerging technologies are coming in these areas. Every day the technologies are changing. Talking about the fundamental technologies, like you talk about like navigation. From there onwards, what technologies, what we were using day before yesterday, what we were using yesterday, what you are using today, and tomorrow, the technologies are changing. You need to cope up with the changing scenario. And so, you need to work on many of the futuristic technologies which are coming up. Whether working with the academic institutes in the country itself, who are more on the basic research, and then applied research related aspects which they give to the R&D organizations to carry from applied research to translational research. Then the strengths which are available internationally on these technologies are the efforts which are being made internationally by various countries, their own R&D organizations in these areas. These days, the cooperations in these areas are very common in the futuristic areas. May not be a critical mission-related cooperation in the present scenario or in the for the present, but definitely for many of the technologies which are required, the cooperation can be always there and people can be working together and developing the things. Need not be particularly in a weapon system, but at the technological front, which probably the countries can independently take towards defense equipment or weaponization. And the many things. Talk about right from fundamentally the materials is one of the important area for most of the countries. The materials availability in the country, the natural resources, are the processing technologies, are the capability to develop many of the alloys, whether you talk about lightweight alloy, very high strength alloy, or very high temperature alloys, maintaining the characteristics at very high temperature, or the composite materials, or the ceramic materials. This is one of the important area for most of the countries in the world. As I said, non-availability of the natural resources, and then of course the technologies. Continuously, this is one area where people are always looking for cooperations. Yes, we are also one of the country where we look for cooperation in development of some of these technologies in the materials area. Having developed many of the technologies like re-entry materials, very high temperature materials and all that, but then it's an area which is always upcoming. I always say one thing, if a country has to be self-reliant, the first two fundamental elements which the country has to be self-reliant are, is first is materials and related technologies, processing and other things and all that. The second one is the manufacturing technologies. If these two are not available in any country, the country cannot be self-reliant and the country cannot be flourishing. So I talk about the second one again, where many countries are actually joining towards each other and trying to have these manufacturing technologies which are upcoming in each and every area, trying continuously research with the industries in these areas. A country like United States of America identified 42 manufacturing areas for different applications or areas and trying to do innovative research manufacturing in those areas and trying to establish institutes, which they have established, I think 28 or so out of the 42, and trying to see that innovative research in that manufacturing capabilities are coming up for the country. Unless you get into the innovative manufacturing capabilities, you won't be able to develop the very critical, crucial, accurate and related type of components or systems, whatever are required. And second thing is, the manufacturing cost also you won't be able to reduce. The manufacturing time also you won't be able to reduce. And then, of course, pollution and other related areas which are required. So this is one of the important things. When India is trying to manufacture, let's say, 110 kilonewtons engine here in the country for the fighter aircrafts, it is a single crystal blade technology what is required for manufacturing these engines. This is one of the important things where the country is working. And from there onwards, when you talk about many things, whether the free space communication using quantum technologies, or talking about today the terahertz technologies where foliage penetration and other areas, what we are talking. And we are talking about today even underwater communications, or very high energy systems, whether you're talking about very high powerful miniature, very high powerful lasers, laser sources of that, are talking about electromagnetic waves, are talking about the propulsion technologies which are required, where range and weight of the system, when you compare, you are trying to make one of the best systems in the world. These are all the technologies what actually future technologies what most of the countries are working. And we are also looking for cooperation from various countries in these areas. Anyone, any academic institute, any R&D organization, who is ready to cooperate in these areas, wherein we can divide the work share, which can be a joint development. I'm not getting into many other details. I've given the top level areas, like you can talk about hypersonics is one of the area which is coming up, which very few nations are pursuing. These are all the areas what, as I said, one of the areas is stealth material, detection of the stealth systems. So these are all the systems which actually countries who have interest, who started their cooperation, who started their research, can cooperate and we can move ahead together. Also like to say that the technologies which are established in the country and which many systems have been produced in the country and many of them in advanced in nature, we are ready to cooperate with many of the countries, of course, guided by our regulations of Ministry of External Affairs. We are, these days you must have been seeing, very aggressively we are trying to discuss, cooperate, or sell various products what are developed in the country, whether it is, again, you talk about missiles or radars or sonars or torpedoes or something like that, these most of the systems what we have developed. We have made a compendium of various technologies and systems what have been made and they have been continuously upgraded. Last year also we have circulated, even this year also we have brought it here, and so all of you can go through it. The technologies and the systems where you are interested, you can talk to us, you can tell us. We'll be happy to interact with you and we are happy to cooperate with you, of course, within the boundaries of MEA guidelines. And even for the systems to sell, whether the systems which are being produced by our DPSUs, Defense Public Sector Units, or the private industries, and wherever the systems need some changes, the modifications and upgradations, as per your requirements, we again from Department of Defense R&D, we are there from DRDO to cooperate, to do the changes, to do the modifications, to upgrade the system and give it as per your requirements. This is another thing what we like to tell all of you. So please go through the compendium, please go through the website of DRDO and Ministry of Defense R&D. You can look at the various technologies what we have developed, we are developing, and what we are looking as futuristic areas also. We are ready to cooperate with anyone who has got interest in that, anyone who can join with us, or anyone who wants to have the technologies and the systems from us. So thank you very much for giving me this opportunity, and once again, nice meeting you once a year. Last year we met and again this year, and hope whatever I have said in that area, in that direction, let us progress together first. Thank you. Jai Hind.